Well, I don't dislike it because I don't dislike anything about Trevor Ariza. Mm-hmm. I think that Trevor Ariza has been screwed over on too many occasions in his career. He should have never departed from Washington with Ernie Grunfeld. If he was there, I think they would have been better off. He should have never departed from Houston. They should have never lost him. And he had to go to Phoenix to get the one-year deal at $15 million because he's been repeatedly underpaid throughout his career. He brings defense, elite defense, I might add, leadership, and experience to any roster that he goes on. So it clearly is a plus. We see, make no mistake about it, a lot of what has ailed the Houston Rockets this year is the fact that Trevor Ariza ain't there. Don't even think otherwise. He has a lot to do with that. Having said all of that, the Lakers' willingness to do this, to pursue this, I'm kind of surprised, Max, because why would you want to do this if you got Kuzma and Ingram? Now, obviously, against defense and experience is the reason why. But his arrival is going to compromise somebody's minutes in that equation. Now, in order to get the deal done, you've got to have cooperation from Kentavious Caldwell-Pope because he's 1 year at $12 million, and that's the guy the Lakers would be willing to unload. But they need his permission in order to do it because he can veto any kind of trade. And by the way, if you were wondering how LeBron had been in the works for a while going to L.A., here's how you know. Rich Paul represents LeBron, mm-hmm. represents Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Max Kellerman, I asked this question facetiously only to make you laugh. What the hell is KCP doing with veto power on a trade? That's all you need to know. The fact that he can veto a trade. Listen, I like Kentavious, but he's not going to be confused with being a superstar in his league, but I like him. He can play, and he can play better. And I think the multitude of personalities and bodies they have on that roster have compromised him. So I think he needs to go elsewhere to remind people of how good he is. But you don't need to be having veto trade power if you KCP. Something wrong with that picture. I don't know. There's only one reason he could have gotten that, and we know why.
Yeah, well, and also Rich Paul is the reason that KCP wound up getting $15 million for a year and then 12 million, 17 and then 12 million, but it averaged about $15 million a year last 2 years. Now he's gotten that money. Now
could have got 80, though, but turned it down from Detroit. Remember that.
But he's going to be back up to that after this next deal for 2 or 3 years at whatever that is. Mm-hmm. I don't know if he's good or not. He's okay. Like he can
he's
shoot.
Decent.
He's decent. We'll see if in a good year he might be very valuable. I don't know that he's really had a good year yet on a team that's looking to win.
Not for the Lakers.
If the trade for Trevor Ariza is for KCP and no real draft capital, okay.
It's going to be draft
capital. If they have to throw in a real draft pick to get it done, no good. Ariza is a nice fit really anywhere because he's a real 3-and-D guy with veteran experience, but he's in decline. Mm-hmm. His defense isn't quite what it was. He doesn't shoot the three quite as well. So he's a nice little piece, but nothing you want to mortgage the future about. It's not like the Lakers are about to win a championship. Yeah. And that's where Ariza is. If you can get him at a reasonable price, mm-hmm. fine. Nothing more.
Well, you got to remember, when you say mortgage the future, let's make sure we highlight and really define what that is. For the Los Angeles Lakers, the future isn't necessarily draft capital. It was when you weren't making the playoffs, but it's not necessarily that now. What it is making sure you don't compromise your agenda in free agency. And the fact that Trevor Ariza is on a one-year deal and he comes off the books doesn't compromise anything that they want to do, which is why I would somewhat disagree with you about that because I don't think it's that big of a
also
risk.
Also, look at the lineup mm-hmm. with Ariza in it. Ingram is not a 3-and-D guy. He doesn't mm-hmm. shoot the three. Now think of the Lakers. Rondo at the point, let's say.
Yep.
Lonzo Ball, but really Rondo. Mm-hmm. Josh Hart at the two. Mm-hmm. At the three, you got Ariza.
He's a spot-up three, but remember, he's the same guy that shot 0 for 12 in the game seven.
But he's a 3-and-D guy, and at the 4-5, Kuzma, LeBron, mm-hmm. that's actually a lineup that maybe can win a playoff series, maybe if
Lakers going to conference finals.
If it's just right,
God,
too.
Here we go. Let's move on. Oh, God.